were working in the logging camps in the northern part of the state, who made their way down at about this time of year, early March, when the log drive was on. Where I grew up in New Hampshire, the logging was the most important industry. I grew up in the White Mountains, the highest mountains in the Northeast, and logging was the main thing. And so many of what we call the shanty boys used to go out on the whitewater rivers. The nearest one to me was the Pemigewasset River. And they used to go out on great big rafts with poles, and so many of them drowned in the rapids. They would fall off and get crushed to death by the logs that were going down to the sawmill. But in Virginia, they did it in grand style. They took the logs downstream on a steamboat packet. Nobody got killed then. But we've got a great, we've got a new CD coming out in sometime, like maybe the late fall, for Fellside, and it's going to have a picture of those Sandy Boys on the front. It's going to be called Sandy Boys, and named after this tune. And the Sandy Boys, the words developed because one of the Sandy Boys fell in love with the daughter of the fellow who owned the sawmill. He was very wealthy, and he fell in love with this very wealthy young woman. And he decided he was too shy to court her, so he got one of the other Sandy Boy loggers to court her for him. And they decided to dress him up as a bugaboo, which is a black expression for a ghost. Now, I don't know about you, but if anybody courted me dressed up in a sheet, I would run 100 miles. I don't know. Something a little strange about that.
A woman under his underwear. Before I made a balloon.
Yeah. Do come along, Sandy Boys. Do come along. Do come along. Do come along, Sandy Boys, waiting for the bugaboo.
Thank you. hands in our hands.